These shots weren't filmed, these were generated with Google's latest VO 3.1 model. But I didn't use Gemini's API directly, I used Replicate instead, which offers us tons of AI models and which makes it incredibly easy to build our own AI tools. In this workflow, we can generate videos either by a simple prompt, by combining a prompt with a starting image that should be animated, or by combining a prompt with a first and last frame. VO then generates the sequence between these two frames for us. The final video gets automatically generated and stored on Dropbox. All of this happens inside n8n, a no-code automation tool. You can think about it as a visual backend builder. I'm using a simple form to collect everything. We provide a prompt, we define some general settings for our video, like the aspect ratio, the resolution, and the duration. All of this can be found on replicate.com. You can explore a lot of different video models here, or just search for VO 3.1, and there you can find all the required code you need to run this model with Replicate in the background. The fields I just talked about can be found under Schema. There you find the image, the prompt, the duration, the last frame, and the resolution. So by just adding all this basic information, maybe setting audio to false, and submitting the form, the first node was executed. Now we go to our switch node, which simply defines the route we take for the video generation process. We can execute this step now and continue with the actual image generation step. This is an HTTP request, a simple post request, which targets the URL we can find in the VO 3.1 documentation on Replicate. So this is my URL. And all remaining information for this node is also taken from the documentation. So we have to enter authentication. So you need an API key to interact with Replicate. We have the header with the content type and the prefer field. And then we send our body, which is JSON. And this simply contains our different input fields for the video generation, the prompt, the aspect ratio, and so on, all the fields we defined in our initial form. In n8n, you can add all these fields via drag and drop, so you simply provide the name, like prompt, and then drag and drop this prompt directly to the corresponding field. This makes it really easy to use. It makes this whole node-to-node connection process very powerful, actually. With all our data being implemented, we can now generate the video. To get the video, we need two more nodes, two more HTTP requests, two get nodes. The first one targets our create video node, and there specifically for the URL, we take the get field, this one down here. This allows us to use the video URL in the next step to download it. If we execute this step, we now get an output field, which we didn't have before, and this field can now be used to download the video. You see it's an MP4 file already. This means on to the next node, the download video node, which is simply another get node with the output field, this one here, added as the URL. And after this step, we finally see if our video generation was successful. So we can download the video also directly in here or have a look at it via view. And we see some happy people. It's a 4-second video as we specified it. It doesn't have any audio. It's a 16:9 aspect ratio. So everything seems to work as intended. Finally, I want to download this video to my Dropbox folder. This is a node n8n ships with. So we set up our Dropbox node. We add the file path. In my case, I used an app folder for my Dropbox API with the path videos, VO 3.1. And here, as we are working with a binary file with this code here, we can access the binary file named data. And inside this file, I want to access the file name, which contains a name, this ID, and the file extension MP4. Switching on binary file and referring to the correct input field, which is again data up here, will initiate the Dropbox upload. And here inside my folder, we have the finished video. Although I'm not the biggest fan of the Gemini API documentation, also one of the reasons why I'm using Replicate instead, Google says that it's great for dialogue and sound effects, cinematic realism, and creative animation. Now, why don't we just quickly create free videos based on these settings? So here I let ChatGPT create some dialogue. So we should hear in the video, "Did you ever think we chose the wrong side?" and a "Maybe, but it's too late now." And note that the dialogue is in single quotation marks. Also, don't put any blank lines in between, so it should be one text block, basically, one line of text. If we submit this...
"Do you ever think we chose the wrong side?"
"Maybe, but it's too late now."
And not too bad, actually. Let me show you two more examples before we dive into the prompts combined with images. This is our cinematic composition now, so a drone shot soaring above snow-covered mountain peaks at sunrise. We'll see if this fits into a 4-second video, but still, this is our cinematic video now. Also really good, as I must say, and the generation didn't take long. It was maybe around a minute, 2 minutes, not more, so I'm impressed. And my last prompt is an animation of a forest made of golden gears and mechanical trees, etc. So that's the animation part. Let's also have a look at the result here. Yeah, a bit strange, but I guess this was the whole point behind it. You can create videos which are up to 8 seconds long. Now that we created videos based on prompts, we'll dive into a workflow that's a bit more complicated. So now we upload an image and tell the AI with our prompt that this image should be animated. We take this little friend here, we provide the image. So this is the switch node. The first routing is not true because our image field is not empty. The second route is also not true because our last frame field is empty. So the third option, is not empty, is true. Therefore, this is the route we're going to take here. Output 2. We can also view our little friend in here. So we go down this green line to upload image. Because what's happening now is, as I'm using Dropbox, I'll first upload this image to my Dropbox folder. Then I'll create a pre-signed URL, so basically a Dropbox link that anybody who I share it with can access and therefore also access the file. So this link must contain the actual path and the file name and extension. Based on this information, we can create the video. So in the upload image node here, we simply upload the image file. So again, the binary from the previous switch node, the file we uploaded, which must be our input field, to a folder of our choice. Here I have a videos uploaded path where I add all the different files I want to handle here in my video creation workflow. We get this path display field. That's the one pointing towards our image, so doc.jpg. In the next step, where we create the pre-signed URL with a post request to the Dropbox API, that's the link you need for a temporary link, which expires after, I think, 4 hours. We just send the headers with content type. And down here, we send the body with JSON, which is actually just the path field that contains this path display field that we created. So that's the path. By executing this, we get our link. That is the pre-signed link that gives anybody access to this image on my Dropbox folder. This means we can now go to our Create Image node, which is basically the same one we had before for our first route. The only difference down here is in our JSON field that we also have an image field that contains this link field we just created, so our pre-signed URL. The image generation process is now the same, so if everything worked as intended, we should then get a video with the starting frame being the one that we saw on the image, but then the animation should continue and a 4-second video should be generated. So we can now go to our get video URL step once again, download the video and upload it to our Dropbox. And this is our little dog here animated now. And for the final video, we'll provide a first and a last frame. I just want to have a video sequence between the two provided images. which I now add here. So the starting image and the last frame. We execute the workflow. We know the switch node already, which now redirects us to the second route here. And as you see, this route is a bit more complicated as we have a Dropbox upload node, as we know it, and a merge node. The point behind it is that in my Dropbox node, I have these two binaries, which I need to upload the file. But if I finish the first file upload, I wouldn't be able to access the second binary. Therefore, we have this little workaround where we have the switch being connected to the merge and the first Dropbox upload node. So in this merge now, after executing the Dropbox upload, we'll have access to both binaries if we also execute the merge in here. And with these two binaries being available, we can now use the second binary file, last frame, here in my second Dropbox upload node. That's the whole point behind this construction here. Now we pre-sign our two URLs, same process as before, create the video and upload it to Dropbox. Well, the bird suddenly got additional wings, but I guess that's okay for the moment. And that's it also for this demonstration of Veo 3.1. With this workflow setup, you can easily play around with it, create some videos, and see what Veo 3.1 is capable of.